evening, everyone. My name is Melissa Sisco. I'm one of the assistant principals here at the high school. And I'd like to welcome everyone to our fall concert, highlighting our high school symphonic band, directed by Mr. Ron Haldeman, and our wind ensemble, directed by Mr. Mark Woods. Our students have been working extremely hard for our performance tonight, and they're really excited to perform for all of you. We are excited to be in this beautiful auditorium, and we ask that you refrain from any food or beverage other than water, so we can keep it as magnificent as it is. So thank you for that. And we'd like to take a minute to remind you of our fire exits in the back and on the sides in case of an emergency. And also we would like to thank Ms. Kirsten King for running our lighting and our sound and our live stream. She's been so helpful in all of our productions. So a little bit of thanks for Kirsten. And now I'd like to introduce Andrew Landis, who will get our concert started. I hope everyone enjoys the show.
Our first piece we'll be playing tonight is the Star Spangled Banner, which is the national anthem of the United States. The lyrics come from Defense of Fort McHenry, a poem written by an amateur poet, Francis Scott Key, on September 14, 1814, after witnessing the bombardment of Fort McHenry by British ships of the Royal Navy in the War of 1812. Key was inspired by the large U.S. flag with 15 stars and 15 stripes, known as the Star Spangled Banner, flying triumphantly over the fort during the U.S. victory. The poem was set to the tune of a popular British song, and although the poem has four stanzas, only the first is commonly sung today. The Star Spangled Banner was recognized for official use by the United States Navy in 1889 and by President Woodrow Wilson in 1916, and was made the national anthem on March 3, 1931, that was signed by President Herbert Hoover. We now ask you to please stand for the playing of the national anthem.
Thank you. to our performance tonight. This next piece is called Beyond the Cosmos, composed by David Schaefer. This is a journey into the expanse of deep space and beyond with this vivid work that captures the beauty and awe of the universe. Powerful and majestic, it also contains quiet and reflective moments of musical beauty before closing with a dramatic flair. It is a total interstellar experience. Thank you.
Thank you.
For our next piece, Into the Arctic, was inspired by the recent brutal winters involving the polar vortex. This piece was commissioned by the Michigan School Band and Orchestra Association to explore the concept of ice, portraying both its beauty and treachery. To best represent the continent of Antarctica, you may notice that the harmonic language constantly walks a fine line between mild dissonance and consonance, striking a balance between the sparkling beauty of ice and the danger that it brings. We hope that you will enjoy Into the Arctic, the Symphonic Band's final performance of this evening.
I'm the Wind Ensemble director. One Thank everyone for coming out tonight. We're very much looking forward to performing for you. Introducing our first song tonight is percussionist extraordinaire Olivia Cornell.
Titled The Claxon, which was composed by Henry Fillmore. It was written in 1930 for the Cincinnati Automobile Show. The composer invented an instrument made up of car horns for the occasion, and while the instrument didn't survive, the march was a huge success. Please enjoy.
Thank you.
had a joke with the next two about introducing that they should go to different microphones, but I guess they're going to be the same one. So we have from our saxophone section introducing our next song, Grace Hayes and Sophia Arden.
Our next piece is composed by Brian Balmages.
It encapsulates the feelings of summer through various lyrical and smooth progressions alongside bright and pulsing rhythms.
This is a challenging piece, but one we all adore.
We hope you enjoy summer dances.
So yeah, I do just want to mention, this is definitely our challenging song. Kind of beginning of the school year, I always like to start with a couple songs that I know that they can sight read pretty easily. And then I started making like songs where I go, okay, we can do some of these for the concert. And they got through the first one in like one rehearsal. So I'm like, all right, so let's try to pick things up a level. So pulled this one out. This is a NISMA level 5. Last year we got one NISMA level 5, and it took like pretty much all year to get to a performance level. This time we did it in basically October and beginning of November. So they've done a really good job with this very challenging piece here. So I do want to thank them for their hard work, and I'm really looking forward to what we can get done the rest of the year.
Thank you.
last time, I want to thank you all for coming out tonight. Our final song tonight is going to be introduced by, hopefully, Mr. Ethan Boone. Good, he came back.
So, this song is Nemesis by Gary D. Zeke. It has, like, lots of dynamic highs and melodic lows. It's honestly a really fun piece. I really enjoy playing it. I hope you guys enjoy listening to it. This is Nemesis.
Percussion in the song. We'll be right back.